We have been coloring Neptune wrong all this time. What if I told you that this image doesn't depict one planet, but two distinct celestial bodies? Look closely and you'll recognize them. Uranus on the left and Neptune on the right. Now you might be thinking, wait a minute, isn't Neptune supposed to be a much deeper shade of blue? We've all seen it in textbooks, with Neptune presented as this vivid blue marvel. But my friends, it's time to unravel the truth. Neptune has never been that strikingly blue. It turns out that what we've been seeing was nothing short of a colossal mistake, akin to using a photo editing app to enhance colors for that perfect Instagram post. Somewhere along the line, those responsible for showcasing Neptune's images went a bit overboard with the image processing. Fortunately, scientists have now rectified this error, revealing Neptune's true colors, which happen to be much closer to its celestial companion, Uranus. Brace yourselves, for our textbooks will never be the same again. Uranus and Neptune. In images capturing the outermost planets in our solar system, Uranus typically appears as a pale green orb, while Neptune tends to exhibit a much bluer hue. Uranus is the seventh planet from the Sun classified as an ice giant. It orbits at an average distance of approximately 1.8 billion miles from the Sun, taking about 84 Earth years to complete one orbit. A distinctive feature of this planet is its extreme axial tilt of about 98 degrees, causing the planet to rotate almost completely on its side, likely due to a past collision with a massive object. In terms of size, Uranus is the third largest planet in our solar system after Jupiter and Saturn. Its composition primarily includes hydrogen and helium with traces of methane, water, and ammonia, contributing to its distinctive blue-green color. This pale blue planet possesses a thick atmosphere featuring some interesting dynamic weather patterns. Winds in its upper atmosphere can reach speeds of up to 560 miles per hour. This planet has a system of rings, though they are less predominant than Saturn's and 27 known moons, with the largest named after characters from the works of Shakespeare and Pope. What about Neptune? You can find this amazing planet 2.8 billion miles from the Sun, completing one orbit in approximately 165 Earth years. Similar to Uranus, Neptune has an axial tilt, although less extreme at about 28 degrees. Just like Uranus, Neptune is primarily composed of hydrogen and helium, with methane leading its distinctive blue color to the planet's atmosphere. This ice giant features a thick atmosphere. Remarkable is the presence of active weather patterns, including storm systems and fast winds. Neptune possesses a system of rings, though they are faint and dark, consisting of small particles. If you want to know more about Neptune's rings, make sure to watch our previous video. Previous studies. The distinct visual appearances of Neptune and Uranus, despite sharing similar characteristics like mass, size, and atmospheric composition, have intrigued astronomers. Neptune stands out with its vivid blue color in the visible light spectrum, while Uranus presents itself in a lighter shade of cyan. Recent astronomical research delves into the factors contributing to these notable color differences. Unraveling the color difference required a profound understanding of planetary formation, evolution, and atmospheric processes. Even NASA joined the effort to explain this intriguing dissimilarity between Neptune and Uranus. Leveraging data from the Gemini North Telescope, the NASA Infrared Telescope Facility, and the Hubble Space Telescope, scientists have formulated a unified atmospheric model that aligns with observations of both Uranus and Neptune. The model discloses that an accumulation of excess haze in Uranus's inert and lethargic atmosphere contributes to its lighter appearance compared to Neptune. NASA suggested that a concentrated haze layer present on both planets is more prominent on Uranus compared to Neptune. This phenomenon contributes to a whitening effect on Uranus's appearance, creating a noticeable difference from Neptune's vivid blue color. Intriguingly, according to this model, without the presence of this haze in their atmospheres, both Neptune and Uranus would share an almost identical blue hue. This discovery stemmed from a comprehensive model developed by an international research team led by Patrick Irwin. Today, we understand that while this model may be accurate, it does not significantly alter the color of Neptune compared to Uranus. Notably, Professor Irwin played a key role in revealing the truth about Uranus and Neptune sharing essentially the same color. Stay tuned to learn more about how Professor Irwin unraveled this cosmic mystery later on in the video. The false colors. The sole spacecraft to explore Uranus and Neptune was Voyager 2, undertaking flybys of both ice giants in the 1980s and transmitting groundbreaking snapshots. Patrick Irwin himself highlights that the spacecraft's images were captured using various color filters, including green, blue, and orange. The subsequent step involved recombining these separate images, and during the image processing stage, decisions were made to enhance specific features of Neptune, such as its cloud bands and a dark spot. Although the Voyager team openly acknowledged these adjustments, Irwin notes that over the decades, the nuances of the image creation process have faded from memory. Consequently, the altered depictions of Neptune and Uranus have solidified over time. For many, these images have become the definitive representation of how the planets appear. However, things have recently changed. Before delving into how Irwin's team of scientists from Oxford uncovered and rectified this long-standing misconception, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can improve it for you, the viewer. Plus, don't forget to subscribe to our channel by making sure to hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of our daily videos. The true colors. The team was recently trying to better understand the clouds on these two planets using data from instruments on the Hubble Space Telescope, as well as the European Southern Observatory's Very Large Telescope. The scientists realized that they could use this data to rebalance the images taken by Voyager 2 and produce color images that you would actually see were you there with the spacecraft looking at the planet. What they found is that Uranus and Neptune actually look almost the same. They're both pale bluish-green. Neptune might be slightly more blue, but the difference is nothing like what you'd see if you just Google for images of these two planets. Their instruments provided continuous spectra of colors, allowing researchers to accurately represent the true colors of Uranus and Neptune. Upon analysis, it was discovered that Uranus and Neptune share a similar greenish-blue hue with a subtle distinction. Neptune exhibits a slightly heightened blue tone, attributed to a thinner haze layer on the planet as revealed by the model. Furthermore, the study indicated that Uranus appears slightly greener during its summer and winter when one of its poles is oriented towards the sun. In contrast, during spring and autumn, when the sun is positioned over the equator, Uranus takes on a bluer tint. Conspiracy or normal procedure? How did this error come about? And why did it go unnoticed until recently? Was there a conspiracy to withhold the truth from the public? Absolutely not. It is important to know that enhancing images is a normal procedure in astronomical research. One would be foolish to look at an astronomy image and think it was not enhanced. They have to be because this is how they are processed in order to see things. Imagine for a second you're trying to capture the essence of a breathtaking landscape with your camera. The initial photo might capture the scene, but it could lack the vibrancy and clarity that your eyes perceive. Similarly, when astronomers obtain raw images of planets through telescope or spacecraft, those images might not fully represent the nuanced features and characteristics present. Processing astronomical images involves employing sophisticated techniques to bring out the subtle details that might be obscured in the initial data. It's akin to adjusting the contrast, brightness, and color balance on your camera to highlight specific elements in your landscape photo. In the case of planets like Neptune, the process allowed scientists to accentuate the planet's atmospheric features, weather patterns, and other significant attributes. This communication strategy played a pivotal role in ensuring that people grasped the concept that Uranus and Neptune were distinct planets. It was essentially a tactical approach, leveraging the human's brain's ability to quickly identify and differentiate between objects with noticeable differences. When celestial bodies exhibit significant variations, the instantaneous recognition by the brain becomes more effective. Conversely, if the planets appear highly similar, there's a greater likelihood of confusion, underscoring the importance of employing strategic communication methods to facilitate clear understanding. In a nutshell, this enhancement was not about distorting reality. Moreover, without these enhancement procedures, important details might remain hidden, making it challenging for scientists to analyze and understand the composition, structure, and behavior of planets within our solar system and beyond. The teaching. The recent Neptune color revision offers us important insights into the world of scientific imagery that everyone, regardless of their background, can appreciate. It highlights the crucial role of accurate image processing in bringing out the true beauty of celestial bodies. This correction isn't just about science, it's about how the colors we see in space are translated from raw data, ensuring that what we marvel at is an authentic representation. Imagine processed images as the storytellers of the cosmos, and the correction of Neptune's color is a plot twist. These images shape our perception of the universe, and the correction shows us the importance of getting that narrative right. It's like updating a favorite story with new details, making it even more captivating. The Neptune color correction is like the cosmic equivalent of that tiny disclaimer in advertisements. You know, the one that's usually smaller than the fine print on your credit card statement? It's like, hey, that stunning blue Neptune you've been admiring? Not exactly how it came out of the space oven. Just like in ads where they casually mention side effects faster than you could say supercalifragilisticexpialidocious, the original Neptune image has its own, oh, by the way, we added a touch of fantasy to the colors note. It's the intergalactic version of saying results not typical, or objects in the image may be less vibrant than they appear. So next time you're gazing at a breathtaking cosmic snapshot or checking out the latest product ad, just remember sometimes the real story is tucked away in the cosmic fine print or the ad's footnote. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching. Which version of Neptune do you like the best? Let us know in the comments below. I'll see you next time on the channel.